We're still here at the Betty Day Centre, where we have with us Dr. Meredith Doig, who's running as an independent with a sex party, or are you with a sex party?
I am a member of the sex party, and I am their lead candidate for the Senate from Victoria.
For the Senate?
For the Senate, for the upper house. Our party leader, Fiona Patten, is already in the upper house of the Victorian Parliament. Would you like to wait until...
So, what are you doing here today? You're just trying to get votes?
Yes, of course, like everybody else. But I do actually live in Melbourne Ports, so this is my electorate. And I know some of the other candidates around, so it's good to say hi. But trying to encourage people to really consider the minor parties in the Senate to keep the bastards honest. Our party leader, Fiona Patten, has done a terrific job in the Victorian upper house. Been very active, and I think a lot of people will recognise that she's really done more in a year and a half in the Victorian Parliament than most minor party politicians do in a whole term. So we'd really like to do in the Senate what Fiona has done already in the Victorian Parliament, and that is work collaboratively across party lines with people who have got common sense and goodwill to really move the action forwards. I mean, I think everybody's a little bit sick of, you know, the major party guys throwing hand grenades at one another and fulfilling the political formula. Yep. So let's see if we can get some common sense in the upper house.
Do you know Sandy Goodman? Do you know who he is?
I don't know Sandy Goodman. Tell me.
He's also known as Ostentatious. And he's been running in the seat where Tony Abbott has been sitting for a long, in Warringah. He's been running against Tony Abbott, yeah, for the sex party. So we're wishing Sandy Goodman, I know you watch the Shtick, mate, wishing him good luck in the elections. And I'd like to wish the sex party good luck as well. I mean, everybody needs a lot of luck to get through, because we just don't know what's going to happen, do we?
Well, it's a new voting procedure in the Senate, so it's a little bit of an open slather. You know, we don't quite know. We don't have the history to go back on. Mm. So, yes, it's going to be interesting to see how it all falls out. I'm not quite sure that the Prime Minister is going to get exactly what he wanted, which was a more compliant Senate.
It's not going to happen.
No, I don't think it's going to happen. But, you know, he needs people like us who are reasonable, that he can deal with. And rather than just say no to everything, we are prepared to deal with people of goodwill and common sense.
Fantastic. So lovely to meet you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Meredith.
Pleasure.
One of the How to Vote people here is Peter Holland.
Indeed. I'm running as an independent, and it's a great thing to do.
Yeah, well, you're really running for local issues.
Well, I'm a grassroots person. I've been involved in grassroots politics here for 30 years. And one issue is the Palais that council intends to lease it out to an American conglomerate for 50 years. And we're running in order to put pressure on the state government to reject that. But there's a second broader issue about transparency in government, and it's a call for more transparency, less secrecy in government generally at all levels.
I think that's a great idea, because I think there's too much graft, corruption, and too much one-sided thinking about, you know, people in control, hold control and don't want anybody to interfere.
Well, we don't have a federal anti-corruption body, and yet Transparency International have their annual survey, and it shows that Australia is becoming more and more corrupt. We used to be the fifth least corrupt, now we're the 13th least corrupt country in the world. It's not good.
No.
We've got political donation laws that are a joke. There's all sorts of loopholes. We've got consultation that's a joke on the Yarra Trams proposal for Ackland Street and the destruction of Brooks Jetty. And we've got all this information that's kept confidential. So we don't get the documents behind the Grand Prix and its costings to the Victorian taxpayer. We don't have the documents behind the rezoning of Fisherman's Bend. When a whistleblower leaks information that should be in the public, like the cost blowouts at the National Broadband Network, there's no protection for the whistleblower. In fact, they set the police onto him. So there's all sorts of ways in which we have to make our government more transparent.
And I think that the issue with the refugees on Manus Island and all of that, where they, if they say anything, then they're likely to go to jail for 2 years.
Well, that's another aspect of open government. Clear government, checks and balances, fair treatment, etc.
Yes. Well, as an independent, you really are in the position. I think there's going to be a lot of interesting outcomes in this election. If independents get elected like they have in the past, they throw a spanner in the works.
Well, I think independents are often running because there's an idea that they want to get into the public debate. Mine is about transparency, and it's something that John Cain's been on about, the father of our freedom of information laws. The Greens are on about it, Xenophon's on about it, but not the major parties.
No.
And so I think everyone should have a look at what the independents are saying. If you like their idea, give them vote one, because they're probably only going to get a few percent, but it gets those ideas into the public domain. And then give vote two to the party that you think is best fitted to run in Parliament.
Yeah, I think the two main parties, Labor and Liberal, have got too much of a monopoly and they're just holding on to power, whichever one gets into power. And I think also that there's too much of a similarity between them, in a sense. They're bipartisan in too many different ways, which I think is a bit of a worry.
It's in their mutual interest to have decisions behind closed doors without the public scrutiny. And so it's the independents and the minor parties and retired politicians like John Cain that have to lead the charge to get a more transparent, more open government.
Yeah, well, John Cain, amongst others, have been in power and they know all the stuff that goes on under the carpet.
Yeah, well, I'm sure that he's shocked at the way governments can use, say, this concept of commercial in confidence to hide documents, or the way they can just send a document up to Cabinet and then it's not available under freedom of information laws. That's why we don't know really how much the Grand Prix is costing the taxpayer. That's why we don't know why the Liberal government rezoned Fisherman's Bend that produced massive windfall profits to speculators.
Yes, we know. So, Peter Holland, it's really good to see you.
Okay.
We're very old friends. And I'd
the good work.
Thank you. I'd love to wish you good luck.
Good on you.
And it's going to be a very interesting election.
It'll be very close here, I think.
Now we're actually going back to another commercial break where we'll be seeing Tim Wilson this time in the studio.